On the eve of the King's coronation, there's been tension between the Māori King's delegation and the government after tikanga was not properly followed at an event. Prime Minister Chris Hipkins joins us now. We really do appreciate your time, Prime Minister. You wouldn't normally join us on a Friday, but this is a special occasion that is happening in the UK. So we really do appreciate that. But we should be talking about the coronation and also about the opportunity for those New Zealanders who are attending the coronation. We should be talking about the celebration. Instead, we're talking once again about tensions between the government and Māori. Is this a regrettable situation that happened there in the UK this afternoon evening?
Yes, I think it is a regrettable situation. A tikanga, or a protocol for how the welcome into the country was going to take place, was agreed, and unfortunately it appears that that wasn't ultimately followed. So I think, you know, a lesson to learn there, and I think it shows that, you know, the relationship between the Crown and Māori is a really important one, and it's something that we need to keep working on to make sure that we continue to improve it.
Nita Simmons spoke with our One News reporter May Heron following what actually happened, and they feel like they've been belittled, and I hear what you're saying in terms of the relationship that's important between Māori and the government and the Crown. It doesn't seem like that is the case though, Prime Minister, when a simple thing like a karakia, which is important when it comes to Māori traditions and tikanga, isn't followed through, and then our High Commissioner of New Zealand to the United Kingdom says that this is the first coronation that anybody in the room has attended. The Kingitanga has had two, Prime Minister. Should there be an apology and an acknowledgement?
I think there already was. I don't think anyone meant to suggest that the fact that we're attending the first coronation for a UK monarch in over 70 years in
it
any way
diminishes the significance of the... It wasn't made clear at the time that it was spoken, though.
And look, and I think that you know, I certainly don't think any offence was intended there, and so I think it's all been subsequently clarified. But I think it shows that, you know, we do need to. I'm sure we will reflect on that and make sure that we're doing better in the future.
Prime Minister, there have been a number of New Zealanders who have joined Indigenous leaders and politicians across the Commonwealth to demand King Charles III make an apology for the effects of British colonisation. And I wonder, do you support these calls?
I think if you look in the New Zealand context, we've actually got a process in place for dealing with the effects of colonisation, the effects of past injustices, and there are apologies that have been issued by the Crown in some cases for things that have happened in the past. So we've got an agreed process. It is a process that's working well, but it's a process that's not yet complete. There's still more work to be done.
Can we move on to the free trade agreement, because the work has been done and finally we've got this thing across the line? How good is this for New Zealand exports?
It's a really big day for New Zealand exporters. The UK free trade agreement is going to open up huge opportunities for New Zealand exports. 99.5% of our current exports will now be covered either tariff-free or through quotas. There's the potential to grow our exports to the UK by up to $1 billion a year, potentially more. That's such good news for the New Zealand economy. It's going to help to create jobs in New Zealand, opportunities for our businesses to thrive here on the other side of the world. I'm just, as you can see, at a function now where we've been speaking to businesses who want to do business with New Zealand. So there's an enormous potential here for us.
Can we talk about what the impacts that will have on New Zealanders and, you know, the benefit to us?
Look, there's huge opportunities here in the UK. We've seen already, you know, some of our export industries thriving here. So New Zealand wine, New Zealand lamb and beef, New Zealand produce, it's in hot demand here. The trade agreement opens up new opportunities for us in areas like technology, like agri-tech. And, of course, it opens up more opportunities for our existing export industries as well.
Prime Minister, I do want to change topics again. Meka Whaitiri, I wonder whether you've actually heard from her yet.
No, I haven't, and obviously I regret that. I think that's unfortunate. But I now know what Meka's decision is. I've seen that through the media, and I acknowledge and respect that she's made her decision, and I wish her well for the future.
And I think you're being very kind about it, but what does it say about, I don't know, the relationship between the two of you, that she hasn't even contacted you, she hasn't even contacted others within the party?
Well, that's ultimately a question for Mecca. I mean, I when I heard the rumours, I got in, or attempted to get in touch with her. I wasn't able to do that. I've always gotten on quite well with Mecca, so you know, I was disappointed on a personal level about that. But ultimately, I don't think it represents anything other than the fact that Mecca has decided that she sees her future somewhere different.
Yeah, and that electorate, the Ikaroa Rāwhiti, are deeply loyal to Labor and a safe seat for you. So how concerned are you that that Labor seat, that safe Labor seat in Ikaroa Rāwhiti, could potentially turn to a Te Pāti Māori seat?
Oh, look, we'll have a candidate in Ikaroa Rāwhiti and we'll put up a good contest. Ikaroa Rāwhiti has been very loyal to Labor in the past and we'll certainly make sure that we're in there in the coming election and making sure that they have that opportunity to continue to do that. But in the meantime, our focus in the whole Ikaroa Rāwhiti area is supporting the cyclone recovery. That's got to be where our focus is over the next few months, well before we start thinking about the general election campaign. There's still a big disaster recovery effort underway there, and that's where we've got to put our energies.
Prime Minister, have you spoken to the Speaker, Adrian Rurafio, about his decision to allow Mecca Whaitiri to remain an MP, despite the fact that she says she informed the Speaker of her resignation from Labor to join Te Pāti Māori, which then would trigger the waka jumping law? Are you satisfied that the Speaker's got the decision right?
No, I haven't spoken to the Speaker. Ultimately, those are decisions for the Speaker. And I think, given the context, it's important that the Speaker makes those decisions independently of the views of the government. I've got confidence that he will do that.
OK, let's move on, shall we, Prime Minister? Let's talk about the sausage rolls. Were they any good? Everybody wants to know, because everybody's been bagging it and not sure whether it was, you know, the right gift, but were they any good?
They were very, very good, and it followed a very warm and convivial conversation with King Charles. It was fantastic to be able to meet with him, you know, he's got a keen interest in New Zealand, and I thought the fact that he'd done his research and gave me some sausage rolls at the end just topped off what was a very good meeting.
Yeah, see, I thought the same too, but I also want to know, did you get any tomato sauce with it?
Well, actually, I didn't have any with the sausage rolls there, but like, the delegation did bring some watties with us. You may see that appear before the end of my travel here.
Just finally, Prime Minister, again, we do appreciate you joining us on a day that you wouldn't normally join us. And so the final question of the day, and amongst everything, is who will you be wearing to the coronation?
I have a new suit from Barker's that I'll be wearing to the coronation on Saturday.
Brilliant. Brilliant. I think most of us guessed that. Thank you so much, Prime Minister Chris Hipkins, joining us from the UK. And enjoy the coronation tomorrow. Tēnā koe.
Thank you. Tēnā koe.